Google has recently launched the Nano Banana image generation and edit model, also called as Gemini 2.5 Flash Image. And this model is regarded as the best image editing model out there. In this video, we are going to compare it with ChatGPT's image editor and Qwen, Grok, and Flux Kontext Max. So it's going to be a crazy battle. I will be giving some images and prompts, and let's see which one does a great job. So this is going to be my input image, an image of a girl, and I'm going to ask each and every model, make her carry a handbag. So I'm giving the exact same prompt everywhere, Qwen, Grok, and here I'm going with the Flux Kontext Max model. So this is also a quite challenging prompt because I'm not giving the handbag image, I'm just giving the image of a girl, and in this also, the girl's hands are not visible. So the model must judge how the handbag is going to look and also judge how or what posture the girl is going to hold that handbag. Let's see what each model gives for this. We have got the output from all the models. Let's compare. So first, this is the output that I got from ChatGPT. I'll just open the image side by side. So the first thing that I noted here is it has done a great job, but I don't know why every time we give an image to ChatGPT, it completely changes the theme or the texture of that image. So here you can see, right, this image is of like different theme or the color grading, and this image is of like different theme. It not only has done the job well, but it like slightly alters the theme. Some people don't care about the color grading or the theme, but some people really want it to be the exact same. But apart from changing the theme, it has really kept the facial expression, hairstyle, background, everything in the place, and it has got the handbag over here. She is carrying it and the hands perfectly placed, dress, everything is good. So ChatGPT has done a terrific job. Next, let's move on to Google AI. So I'll just open it, and Google has also done a great job. And the best thing that I like about the Nano Banana model is, unlike ChatGPT, it doesn't alter the theme or color grading. Here you can literally see, right, both the images are literally the same when it comes to that thing. It's just the exact same thing, and it has just altered my hands and the handbag. Next, let's go with Qwen, and similar issue with Qwen also. So Qwen has like kind of bleached the image, I would say. We have got the girl's face. The girl's face looks slightly different, like a bleachy image. And apart from that, this has also like altered the theme a bit of the image. And if you don't mind about that theme, this has also done a good job. And I really like the posture, because in both of the early images, the girl is literally holding the bag like this. Whereas in Qwen, it has perfectly like put the handbag on her arm. And this is good. And next, let's go with Grok. Okay, Grok has given us two image outputs. The face has been altered slightly, I guess the eye, but apart from that, and Grok has also done a pretty good job over here. Next, moving to Flux, and this is the output from Flux. Yep, Flux has also done a pretty great job over here. Next one, this is going to be my input image, and my prompt is going to be add people. This will be quite challenging. The reason is because the model must exactly figure out where the people has to be put, because we are having sofa, they could be standing or sitting, and it must also make sure that the image generated of the people are not blurry or not disformatted. So that's a challenge over here. Let's see what each model gives for this. Okay, we have got the results. First, let's go with ChatGPT's, and it has added the people. In some places, there is a bit of distortion over here, but apart from that, it has done a pretty good job, and this is my input image. And as usual, it has kind of like change the color grading, but overall it has done a decent job. Next, let's go with Nano Banana. It has added two people over here, and as usual, it doesn't touch or alter the existing image. That's what I really like about Nano Banana when compared to all the other models. And it has added two people, beautifully done. And another great thing is, look at this lighting. I don't know if that lighting was there. Okay, the lighting was there over here, the rays, and it has added a person, and its shadow is over here. That's insane. The level of detail is insane here. And next, let's go with Qwen. Qwen has also done a great job, but slightly it has changed the color grading, the theme and stuff. It has slightly changed it, but apart from that, it has also done a great job. And next, let's go with Grok. Grok has given the output, but it has been fully distorted. I don't know why Grok has given like this. They look like prehistoric humans before 100,000 years. So not the best. And next, let's go with Flux. Flux has also not like impressed me. The people's face doesn't look good. The reason all these models face this challenge is because this isn't like a high quality image, so it's going to be difficult for it. But a model must still perform well. So I would really give this to the Nano Banana and ChatGPT and Qwen. They have done a pretty good job. Next input, a Japanese samurai. And I am going to ask each and every model to keep the face alone in 2D anime style and leave the rest of it to be the same. So it will just convert the face to cartoonish style and the rest will be like realistic, the exact same thing. I've already tried this with Nano Banana and it was doing a great job, and I want to see what all these other models does. And this is extremely challenging because for a model to convert the entire image into anime, it's a piece of cake. But to convert only a specific part of that image, it's going to be difficult, because here I'm not referring or drawing outline this part alone as anime. I'm just sending it. So it must detect the face and then convert it alone without altering the image. So that's the main point of this prompt. Let's see what each thing does. Let's go with ChatGPT first. And it has converted the face to cartoon style, but it has also converted the hands and some parts of the armor. This you can see, right? This is the image, and just look at these portions. This has been fully converted to cartoon. So to be honest, it has converted 50% of the entire character to anime, and it hasn't converted the background. But I asked only the face to be converted. So this is the challenge that I mentioned. Next, let's go with Nano Banana. Nano Banana has done a splendid job. The face is alone converted to anime style, and it has literally kept the background and all the other details the same. No color grading change, no theme changes, no difference in the dress or the background. I think this is the best model when it comes to making alterations in an image without disturbing the existing image background. That's so perfect. It has replicated it 100%. And this is the result that I get from Qwen. Qwen has completely altered the image. Literally, it has converted everything to anime style. Next, with Grok. Same with Grok also. It has converted the entire image into anime style. Next, with Flux. Flux also the same thing. It has converted everything into the anime style. So, this is like a top-notch win, I will say, for Nano Banana AI. None of the models were even close. Quite close was ChatGPT, but the rest three models literally converted the whole image into cartoon. I think this will be the most hardest prompt of all. Here I'm having an image of a stadium and it's fully packed with people. And I'm going to ask each model to remove the people from this image. So it's going to be extremely difficult, because even after removing all the people, it has to visualize how this entire stadium will look without these people. That's another challenge, and obviously the first challenge is to remove the people, because here the people are clearly visible. But if you zoom in, here you can see there are many people, but those aren't clearly visible in this image. So let's see what each model does for this. First, let's go with ChatGPT. ChatGPT has done a terrific job. Like, this is the earlier image. Here you can see the people and stuff. It has retained these two stands. We are having those over here. We are having the stage. The stage is over here. And apart from that, it has done an excellent job, to be honest. It has literally removed all the people. And here also, this particular portion literally comes here. Beautifully, it has created. And some minute mismatches are there, because here you can see, right, there are slightly people, like a few people, it appears to be like that. But overall, ChatGPT has done a terrific work here. Next, let's go with Nano Banana and opening it in a new tab. It has also done a good job. The floor coloring is different. It has gone with the black color. Okay, that's good. And I don't know why there is a single person standing here. And similar to ChatGPT, the challenge was this particular portion. I can see some slight white color. That doesn't look like people, but it would be nice if it had just given the blue finish over there. And another great thing is it has retained this portion where the drums and the musicians will be sitting and performing. Whereas in ChatGPT's response, we didn't have that in much detail. Like here you can see, right? This particular thing is more detailed when compared to ChatGPT's response. And even in the image, it had a lot of things. So apart from that, Gemini has also done a great job. Next, let's go with Qwen. Qwen has done a pretty good job in removing everything. And it has given here seeds. That's the only thing that has been misleading, I would say, because people are literally standing here and definitely this portion should have been empty. Qwen has also done a really good job. Next, when giving with Grok, I don't know what Grok did. Nothing has pretty much happened. It hasn't even removed the people. I don't know why it has put two stages like this, and I don't know what is this. This particular portion has been added. I just said it to remove people. So Grok hasn't given the desired output. Next, with Flux, I don't know what it has done. I can see like a tsunami of people, I would say. I don't know what is this. And yep, so I would say the winners over here are Qwen to an extent, and ChatGPT and Nano Banai have done a tremendous job. So as a conclusion, what I am feeling is definitely Nano Banana AI is worth the hype, and Google have developed the best AI image editing model. That's the reason why it was ranked number one on LM Arena. And apart from the Nano Banana model, I would say the number two place will go to ChatGPT, the image editing model that they have. That's also so good. And the rest are the models, Qwen and Grok and Flux, they also do a good job. But if you ask me, in all the cases, definitely that's a question mark. If you have any other opinion, you can let me know in the comments. That's the video, guys. Do check the playlist of my channel. Done a lot of videos in programming and AI tools.